Kody and I, since COVID, have really been struggling in our relationship. Everything really started to fall apart with the beginning of COVID and the quarantine. Kody didn't feel like my boys were being very safe. He didn't trust them. He thought they were going to contaminate us all. So, I mean, at one point, Garrison, who was very frustrated with how he felt like I was being neglected, called Robin and said, "Hey, can we have our dad back? Because he hasn't been around." Kody feels like Robin's been severely wronged and that my children need to apologize.
I never asked for an apology. I don't want an apology. I want to be able to be okay with these boys, and that was never my intention.
And now, with some prompting from Robin, he's come around to, well, there has to be a conversation. But yet, I still see no movement on his part towards reconciliation.
Where are you going for Christmas?
Here, I'm here. But okay. My kids, they're renting an Airbnb because I don't think they're welcome, right?
I never said my kids weren't welcome.
If they apologize and they're kind of
No. All I want to do is talk to them.
Well, Janelle's going to go back east, see Maddie and Caleb for Thanksgiving. Okay, all right, I get it a little bit, but I am still sore. I'm tender emotionally from a divorce. And this would be the time that I would wish that my wife would look me in the eyes and say, "I support you. Sure, I've been an ogre, but I love you and I support you. And I understand what you're going through." She's not doing any of that. She's literally telling me she doesn't like me. She prefers other things. She even prefers my ex-wife.
After Christmas, Christine said that Isabel and everybody are coming home and they want to come see the family here.
Oh man, this is exactly what I was afraid of with Christine leaving.
Cody, it just was working out that we had a vacation rental, so we extended it so Truly and Isabel can see you.
But you're talking about everybody going to some neutral zone. This is my house.
Welcome to my house in Utah. I'm really so excited, so excited. Like, I left Flagstaff 2 months ago. Yeah, it feels like I'm ripping things apart. I thought that it would just be a little bit easier, but it's an end of a book. It's an end of a saga, I don't know. And so everything just feels a little unsettling.
Christine's gone, and Janelle doing stuff with Christine. She's not doing stuff with the rest of us, or even me. So I don't know what to make of this.
It's tense in the family across the board. It's tense for a couple of different reasons. There's Christine leaving and her divorcing Kody. There's a lot of tension going on. Now they're talking about doing Christmas separate. It's this whole new like worry and heartbreak and stress about whether or not we'll not be together for Christmas. But it's still like horrible to sit and think about. It's like, it's scaring me and stressing me out a lot. From the minute I met the family, we've been doing holidays together, every single holiday together. And this is just such a weird experience to go, who's gonna be together for the holidays? It just seems so screwed up, and I hate it.
I'm visiting Janelle in her apartment today. This is the first time that I get to see it. And she asked if I would come over and help her build the shelf.
Here. Oh, there. Because my steak knives really actually are just really
Oh, no. And Peyton's like, "Make sure you don't use those knives to cut cardboard." I'm like, oh, my gosh. I'm definitely using those knives.
Oh, my word. That looks intimidating.
No, it's not. It's fine. Yeah, I still consider Janelle my sister wife. It's super weird, I think. But it's just that we're not really just friends.
Christine and I, especially when she first came into the family, I just did not get her. I thought she was a princess. I did. And she thought I was bossy.
When I married Kody, I didn't really even know Janelle that much. Like, at first I thought we were okay.
So Christine and I have joked, are we still sister wives? We both say yes, even though it's not really the traditional sense of the word.
See, I thought we would be so much further along in the building process, but that's just taken a long time.
Because the building, how's it going? You're still gonna...
No, I have my plans.
For your house?
Yeah.
I mean, I will say, if anything has come out of this crazy summer where I made a gamble, it wasn't awesome, like, I have a plan.
Can you reach them with your long arms?
Yeah.
I know what the property looks like. I have at least a freaking driveway out of this whole thing.
Okay, I wanna see.
Okay.
So. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for you. Are you excited?
Yes.
When do you think you're gonna break ground and stuff? Any ideas?
Spring, probably.
No, really?
Yeah, and then it takes about, for these little houses, like 6 months, 6-9 months.
I think if Janelle wants to build, then she should definitely build. The thing is, I know they haven't paid off the property.
I don't think we're gonna be building on this property by spring. Coming up with money to pay off Coyote Pass, very difficult. Coming up with a down payment on a house, not hard. We could have done that, but Janelle was refusing to do that.
So it's just small, just 1,200 square feet, because that's what we can do.
1,200?
That's what we can do with the county.
It's a casita.
Yeah. Oh,
so this is like a casita.
Savannah will stay in it while she goes to school or whatever once we build.
Perfect. Yeah.
Right now, the builders are really overwhelmed. There's so much building going on in Flagstaff. But I did have somebody who was familiar with the industry tell me that these little small casitas, because it's a garage with a house on top, go together pretty quick, like 6 to 9 months.
So
it's just
lovely.
Like, it's basically like two bedrooms,
perfect.
A big living room, each two bathrooms, and then you kind of walk out. There's a little tiny dining room and you just walk out.
Decks all around.
Yeah.
Are you excited? I think
the deck all the way around is
going to Is it going to wrap around like right here?
I'm gonna have it wrap. So that's one thing that we've decided since.
Oh my gosh, I'm excited
for you.
And
then, so you'll walk up, there's interior stairs, which I love, so I can pull in the garage and I can go up the stairs when it's snowing and cold. And then there's exterior stairs.
That's absolutely perfect.
Anyway, so I think it'll be.
One floor? Oh, it's two floors. No.
No, this is the.
Main living floor and then, so you have your basement and then the main floor.
Right, the basement's really just the garage.
Oh, that's awesome, congrats, that's super cool. Very nice.
So hopefully that'll by next fall, by the beginning of Savannah's senior year.
I mean, my original goal was to have the house built by the time Savannah starts her senior year next fall, but maybe winter. But I mean, that's if we start in the spring, and I've given up any hope of Kody doing anything to help me.
Seeing Christine for the first time is like, hey, how are you? Well, it's a little uncomfortable, but hope you're doing well. I feel so betrayed after all that I have done for this marriage, and then to have her sort of talk me to the kids, I kind of feel like, in my heart, I just never want to see her again. And I want to spend some time hating her. Anyway, you wanted to talk about Christmas.
Holidays, right? Christmas.
Holidays.
Okay. So I was thinking about leaving a couple of days after Christmas. So like the 27th, we're going to drive down. So we'll be here for a few days between Christmas and New Year's.
Can you guys test in Utah?
So even though you had COVID and everything, you still want us to test?
Well, Aurora hasn't had COVID. And she's...
Wait, seriously? No, so everyone got it but Aurora?
Nope, she never got it. Yeah, isn't that trippy?
I haven't talked to Kody about COVID. I really honestly forgot how concerned he is about it.
You traveled here, you get here, you take the test.
Okay.
What I'd like to do is have them come over. If they can, stay close. Go see everybody else after so that we've got them just solid.
Then they're just going to go up to Robin's house, and I'll just go over to the rental and just hang out with Janelle and the kids. I'm not going to go to Robin's, no. No, let's, no. Why?
When Janelle told us that she and her kids are going to do Christmas separate from us, it broke my heart. I was very sad to hear it.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So Gwendolyn's not going to be here for Christmas. I was sick during her birthday was laid up with COVID.
And you were also out of it. She was.
Was she thinking that was funny too? I was out of my mind. But when I talk about anxiety, Christine, and depression.
I know. And I'm sorry to even laugh a little bit, but Gwendolyn was like, yeah.
You mean that way. It's okay.
I was married to him for 27 years, all right? Every time that guy got sick, it was like the whole world revolved around his being sick.
COVID was overwhelming for me, not being able to sleep and not being able to breathe.
I'm sorry, Kody, her description of you is what's funny. What are you gonna do? Like, you can either laugh about things or cry about things, and if you can't look back with a sense of humor, what a waste.
I was in the fetal position on the floor sobbing. Well, I'm not laughing. I'm not laughing here. I'm not laughing. I haven't been laughing with her leaving. I've never been laughing about this thing. She asked me to stop staying at her place. I wasn't laughing then. She moved my stuff into the garage. I wasn't laughing then. She left with Truly and she left early. I wasn't laughing then. I've never been laughing about this.
My reactions are just terrible today. I'm so sorry. I'm not married to him anymore. It's so freaking awesome.